If you ate any celery today, like I did, you would probably feel better knowing that you don't have to worry about eating any heavy metals along with it. Today, I have a story to tell you about a group of scientists who discovered a new application for non-invasive microtest technology. How can NMT help screen for cadmium accumulation in celery? Some cadmium is found naturally in soil, but more is added in with human processes such as fertilizing and sewage dumping. With more cadmium accumulating in our soil, more plants tend to take it up. It transports through their roots up into the leaves and shoots. That's not good for the plant, and it's not good for the humans who eat them. In humans, excess cadmium over a long period of time can lead to problems in the lungs and kidneys. So that's why this group decided to do the research. They're from Hebei Agricultural University in China, and they were interested in screening different types of celery to see which ones were more resistant to cadmium accumulation. So they exposed 10 varieties of celery to a high cadmium solution, and then measured the cadmium ion flux in the roots. Our technology, NMT, allowed them to take these dynamic flux measurements without invading or damaging the root. So what did their results look like? NMT data is plotted as diffusion flux over time. Negative values indicate influx, so we know the plants were taking up cadmium. Between low cadmium accumulating and high cadmium accumulating varieties, they did find a statistically significant difference in the patterns of cadmium influx. Their results demonstrate the link between the cadmium ion flux measured by NMT and the plant's susceptibility to cadmium accumulation. They concluded that NMT can be a very useful screening tool to measure cadmium accumulation in celery and probably even more foods. Maybe you will be the next one to use NMT for more heavy metal screening to make sure our food is safe. And stay tuned, we have tons more stories just like this, because scientists have applied NMT across countless different fields, gaining high quality physiological data on their live, undamaged samples and coming up with amazing new application ideas. You don't want to get left out, so subscribe to our channel for more application stories. And I'll see you next time.